Welcome to the great promise of closer U.S.-Somaliland ties, an address by His Excellency Musa Bihi Abdi. Please welcome the President of the Heritage Foundation, Dr. Kevin Roberts.
Good morning. Those of you tuning in online, it may not be morning where you are. Hello. Welcome from Washington, D.C. Your Excellency, welcome. And to all of you here in person, what a great day for this country, for the Heritage Foundation, and for the wonderful Republic of Somaliland. Before we begin, I would be remiss if I didn't mention the people of Ukraine, who, as we speak, are battling for freedom, and for many of them, their very lives. May we pray that that conflict ends soon, with Ukraine whole and free. Our hearts and prayers are with them. I also mention Ukraine because it's relevant to our discussion today. In case anyone has missed the last 4,000 years of history, or just the last couple of weeks, I want you to know that the world is indeed a dangerous place. For as much as we are blessed to have peaceful neighbors and oceans to our east and west here in the United States, we can't ever be complacent about our security. That's one of the reasons why it's so important for the U.S. to develop strategic and amicable partnerships, especially with those like our esteemed Somalilander guests here today. Since I'm an educator at heart, I must first walk us through some relevant history. But as I promised my new friend, His Excellency President Abdi, I'll be brief. Somaliland's independence is not currently acknowledged by any country in the world, including the United States. This wasn't always the case, though. Somaliland was briefly independent in 1960 before joining the rest of Somalia. That union was ultimately rejected by the Somaliland people, but not before it was too late. The world had decided that Somaliland was indistinguishable from Somalia, no matter how Somalilanders felt. In the 1980s, rebellions against the brutal dictator in power broke out against Somalia, including in Somaliland. Somalia's armed forces devastated Somaliland during the fighting, practically flattening its capital city. It may, in fact, have been the only conflict in history that featured aircraft taking off from a runway in the same city they then attacked with bombs. That was just one of the cruelties of that war. In 1991, the dictatorship collapsed, but the fighting continued throughout Somalia, dragging it into failed state status for two decades. We're probably all familiar with the Battle of Mogadishu, better known in the U.S. as the Black Hawk Down incident. Those awful events took place in 1993 during the period I'm describing. We might also be aware that an al-Qaeda affiliate, al-Shabaab, began conquering swaths of southern Somalia in the 2000s. This group, which is still powerful, had links to some of the men who perpetrated the 1998 bombings of the U.S. embassies in Kenya and Tanzania. I'm recounting all this because it highlights how remarkable Somaliland's experience has been. It was and is the exception to Somalia's turmoil. After 1991, it redeclared independence and created a functioning state with its own army, passport, currency, foreign policy, and very importantly, free elections. Foreigners can walk around Hargeisa without security, and ISIS and al-Qaeda have virtually no presence there. It's hard not to admire building a viable state amid such difficult circumstances. How Somalilanders have achieved all this is equally commendable. They had a powerful claim for international sympathy after the devastation they suffered during the war, but they didn't wait for help from anyone else. If they had, they'd still be waiting today. No, they went instead about the business of building their country largely on their own. The clans that had been on opposite sides of the fighting reconciled and in the process created one of the few examples of a successful indigenous peace process. They committed to building something that was peaceful, democratic, and workable. This brings me back to why I think the U.S. and Somaliland should be strong partners. First, this territory of its own accord has stuck with a democratic system and process for three decades. It hasn't been perfect. Just like no democratic system is perfect. But the old saying is that character is how you behave when no one is watching. Well, Somaliland has stayed faithful to democracy when hardly anyone was noticing. This is proof of genuine belief. Second, let's envision where Somaliland sits. The Bab el-Mandeb Strait, a shipping choke point that carries much of the trade between Europe and Asia, is about 70 miles away. Yemen, where American allies are fighting Iranian-backed militias and al-Qaeda, is just across the Gulf of Aden. Somaliland shares a border with Ethiopia, Africa's second most populous country, and in normal times, a landlocked economic dynamo. Somaliland's recently renovated Berbera port has great potential for boosting the economy of Ethiopia and its neighbors in East Africa. Right next door to Somaliland is Djibouti, which hosts a number of foreign military bases, including China's most prominent military footprint on the continent. To the west, and also in a commanding position on the Bab el-Mandeb, is Eritrea. In January, Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi visited Eritrea and announced a strategic partnership with that country. We need to be clear-eyed about the competition we're in with the Chinese Communist Party. The Chinese Communist Party is America's single most formidable opponent and is devoted to advocating for autocracies like itself and Russia by violating the peace and prosperity of nations that refuse to kowtow to it. America must meet this challenge with resolve. That would include a close relationship with Somaliland, given its strategic position, its pro-American orientation, and that almost alone in Africa, it's been immune to Beijing's overtures and threats. In fact, Somaliland has established ties with our Taiwanese friends, another unrecognized democracy that the United States should support. Those of you familiar with East Africa know it is a tough neighborhood. Sudan's hopeful democratic transition has been sabotaged by a coup, one of the leaders of which, by the way, was recently in Russia to strengthen ties with Putin's criminal regime. Ethiopia is caught in a terrible civil war that we also pray will end soon. Eritrea is an international pariah and one of five countries that just voted against a UN resolution condemning Russia's invasion of Ukraine. Southern Somalia is paralyzed by political battles, and al-Shabaab is still strong. Amid all this volatility, Somaliland has enjoyed relative calm, providing evidence that there is, in fact, fertile ground for a truly sustainable partnership. Finally, I believe, and call me crazy, that American policy is most effective when it is tethered to reality. We will see few gains in East Africa if our policy there does not account for the on-the-ground truth that Somaliland has been functionally independent for decades. Count on the Heritage Foundation for always trumpeting that fact. So let's upgrade our policy. The United States of America should strengthen its position in a precarious and important part of the world. It should do the justice of honoring the consistent aspirations of millions of Somalilanders to rule themselves. And America should proudly be the first state to recognize Somaliland as an independent nation. We look forward to that day. In the meantime, it is my honor to introduce His Excellency, the President of Somaliland, Muse Bihi Abdi. Sir.
I would like to extend my sincere gratitude and appreciation to Dr. Kevin Robert, President of the Heritage Foundation, for inviting me to give the address today. The Heritage Foundation stands out among the America's leading public policy institutions to promoting a truly interdisciplinary approach to understanding the politics of the and economics of East Africa. It is therefore a great pleasure and honor for me to exchange views today on Somaliland and the future of our region with such a distinguished participant. Ladies and gentlemen, today the whole world is a laser focused on the tragedy in Ukraine. The shelling, the bombardment, the destruction, the death, the mass suffering, and the largest refugee crisis in Europe since the World War II. Today, the suffering of the people of Ukraine is unfolding in front of our eyes with the help of the 24/7 news cycle and the social media. For us, as Somalilanders, the tragedy is reminiscent of the genocide committed against our people 33 years ago. A tragedy I myself witnessed firsthand, and which over the 550,000 of our people were massacred in the hands of Somalia government at that time. And millions of our people became either refugee or were internally displaced. We feel the pain and the anguish that the people of Ukraine feel today because we went through the same experience. Only in our case, the genocide committed against our people was hidden from the world, as at that time there were no 24/7 days news cycle and the social media. However, the better memory of what we went through is forever be memorialized in the minds and will never be forgotten by our people. Ladies and gentlemen, I come here before yesterday to tell and to talk about my country's progress, challenges, and the role our country plays in the security, stability, and economic development in our region and beyond. Somaliland's geopolitical significance and shared interest with the like-minded countries. First, the security situation in Somalia has deteriorated dramatically, proving a re-evaluation of the political consideration that embedded more direct engagement between the US and Somaliland. As you will recall, the United States re-established diplomatic ties with Somalia in 2013, guided by a vision of an empowered central government in Mogadishu that could build domestic unity among the disparate clans, degrade and defeat extremism, and protect its people and the neighbors from the scourge of terrorism and instability. That vision was unlikely not realized. Today, even the most committed empowering the Mogadishu regime have lost faith in that project. Time and time again, Mogadishu's partners have expended financial resources, diplomatic resources, and military resources with a little show to be with their effort. Regrettably, after nearly a decade of good intentions by Mogadishu partners and considerable US and international assistance, the Somalia government lacks legitimacy and struggles to exercise its authority beyond Villa Somalia. It remains the source of instability in our fragile region. Secondly, the major development in the Horn of Africa has become a region of heightened strategic importance. In a difficult neighborhood, Somaliland's stability and reliability is increasingly recognized as an asset to the advancing the interest of countries with which we share the same values. In recent years, the stability of the Horn of Africa has been challenged by conflicts in the region, as well as the constantly evolving operations of terrorist groups. Instability and food security and food insecurity is further exacerbated by the drought, desertification, locust swarms, and climate change effects. Simultaneously, the Babel-Mandan Strait has emerged as a vital strategic link in maritime trade routes connecting the Atlantic Ocean and Mediterranean Sea to the Indian Ocean. Significantly, a portion of the world's oil passes through Babel-Mandan, as well as considerable trade between Europe and Asia. Its importance is reflected in the expansion of foreign military bases and build-up of naval forces in the Red Sea, as well as enhanced international cooperation to fight piracy and ensure maritime security. Great powers competition in Africa will continue for the foreseeable future. In this environment, the United States should make clear its support for governments that embrace democratic governance and stability in the midst of threats, instability, and external pressures. Major developments: Somaliland emerges as a trade and shipping hub. The modernization of Berber Port, the opening of a new international airport, and construction of commercial corridors to inland neighbors and connecting the Horn of Africa to global trade routes, serving as a linchpin for renewed economic development in East Africa. Last June, our government and DP World of the Emirates inaugurated a new container terminal at Berbera Airport, marking the completion of the first phase of a significant port expansion project. This was followed in October with DP World and Britain's Development Finance Agency announcing plans to jointly invest a significant amount of money in logistics infrastructure in Africa, sharing with further modernization of Berber Port. These investments, combined with the ongoing challenge in neighboring countries, make Somaliland the most stable and reliable conduit between much of East Africa and the world's major shipping lines. Taken together, these three developments, the challenge the international community confronts in the Horn of Africa is increasingly strategic importance, and Berber's potential to create a new economic engine for the region means that Somaliland is poised to become a key player in global security and economy. Somaliland and Somalia, or Somaliland Dialogue and Somalia. The Somaliland-Somalia dialogue started with the London Conference of 23 February in 2012. Article 6 of the London Conference stated that the conference recognized the need for international community to support any dialogue that Somaliland and TFG, Transitional Federal Government, or its replacement may agree to establish to clarify their future relations. The key point here is to clarify the future relations between the two countries. Therefore, in order to clarify the future relations between the two countries, the core issue of the dispute, namely the status of Somaliland, would have been addressed and resolved. Despite 9 rounds of talks between 2012 and 2022, the expected outcome of the talks resolving the one issue of the dispute, the status of Somaliland, never materialized, as there were no political breakthrough. The limited agreements made on the peripheral political breakthrough, the limited agreements made on the peripheral technical issues were never implemented, as Somalia reneglected on all the agreements. During these 10 years, Somalia has demonstrated a complete lack of interest in meaningful dialogue. In fact, Somalia has used the dialogue to pursue policies aimed at weakening Somaliland's independence and its stability, to develop, including weaponizing international aid and economic development. Given that there has been no progress over the last 10 years since the dialogue between Somaliland and Somalia started, Somaliland believes that the dialogue had failed to achieve its objective. The reasons for failure lies entirely with Somalia. Efforts to undermine the dialogue process, as demonstrated by its harmful actions, willful disregard to the agreements we have agreed. Given that dialogue is not an option for Somalia, as demonstrated by its conduct, bad faith, and continuous sabotage of the dialogue, Somaliland believes that it's unfair to Somaliland to be beholden to dialogue process that has failed to achieve its objectives and has no hope of succeeding. It is that difficult to imagine that what has not been achieved in 10 years can be achieved in 1 or 2 years. Somaliland believes that there is no future in the continuation of that dialogue with Somalia and is prepared to pursue all available avenues for its international recognition. Given above, Somaliland believes that the international community has a moral obligation to support Somaliland's pursuit of international recognition. The merits and promise of closer U.S.-Somaliland collaboration. In fact, this chapter has already begun. From regional security to democracy promotion to economic development, the objectives and values sought by the United States align entirely with Somaliland's vision. Recent months have seen an increase in engagement and collaboration, including productive visits by Somaliland Foreign Affairs to Washington and the recent visit to Hargeisa by a delegation of senior U.S. congressional staff. a historic first for Somaliland. I'm very heartened. I am very heartened by these developments, by sustained direct dialogue and partnership is needed if we are to effectively address the growing challenges and truly advance our shared security, economic, and governance objectives in the region. An important foundational element of this partnership is the establishment of the Parliament, U.S. diplomatic presence in Hargeisa, to establish of a permanent U.S. diplomatic presence in Hargeisa. Several nations, including Ethiopia, United Kingdom, Denmark, Kenya, Taiwan, Turkey, and the United Arab Emirates have diplomatic offices in our capital, and the United States of America should join their tasks, their ranks. With this presence and regular visits by senior U.S. officials, we will be able to cooperate more closely in a number of key issues and key areas. Let me briefly highlight a few areas where Somaliland's capabilities and proven track record can be valuable resources for like-minded countries. As I noted earlier, Somaliland has successfully deterred threats to our homeland and piracy in our territorial waters. Our Coast Guards work with partners such as the United Kingdom to guarantee the safety and the security of maritime trade through the Red Sea and the Gulf of Aden. We work with foreign partners and international NGOs to minimize illicit trafficking and smuggling networks. We have much to offer in terms of community-based security successes and closer collaboration with the United States on these efforts would advance shared interests and strengthen its needed presence in the region. Similarly, our recent modernized infrastructure, particularly the Port of Berbera, is well positioned to support security operations, logistics, and humanitarian aid, as well as expanded commercial opportunities throughout the region. We appreciate U.S. government's interest in PEPRA and hope discussions will continue to explore utilization and further development of what could be a vital gateway for trade, investment, and security cooperation between the two countries. On governance issue, Somaliland's democratic government is the only, I will say again, it's the only one of its kind in the region. It serves as a beacon for our neighbors and others whose citizens seek opportunities to engage in democratic process. Over the last 30 years, we have built our democratic norms and institutions and ensured more free peaceful transition of power. We are aware that there are still certain issues to be addressed to ensure that our electoral process is more perfect. We are working on ways and means with our laws of enhancing the role of women in our political process and increasing their participation as candidates in future elections. Somaliland has much to offer others seeking to build their own democratization process, from updating voter registration systems to to ensuring the objective